Welcome back, my dear students. As we are studying that parts of the lathe machine, so here we have studied here now how to fit the workpiece in between the chuck and the center here now. For that we are using the headstock in which motor gear arrangement, that rotational whatever that arrangement it is there, that is fitted, and another one is a it is a tailstock which will gives that rotational support to the workpiece here now. This tailstock can be moved horizontally based on the length of the workpiece, how much it is there. So next one, the tool. The tool is a single point cutting tool, like this one now. Single point cutting tool. We have to fit it here now, because to remove that metal, we have to fit it here now. How to fit it here now? So, because we need the movement for the tool also here. So, how to fit it here? The main arrangement for this one is here. So, here. Here. Two supports are there here at these two sides. And the next one is there are two very important the guide wedges are there, feed rod and lead screw here now. So here is the lead screw here. Lead screw means it is just like a screw here. It is a screw here now. This is called as the lead screw. Lead screw. Another one is feed rod here. On this feed rod, there is no screws are there. Screw like threads are not available on this. It is called as a feed rod here now. Feed rod here in this case. This is feed rod. This is lead screw here. So what is the main arrangement here now? This lead screw is there. This lead screw. Main important, this lead screw is connected to this the headstock by the gear arrangements here. This lead screw is rotating here by what? By the gear systems. That gear system is connected to the motor here now. That means what? Lead screw can be rotated automatically with the help of the motors here now. This is a lead screw. And this other one is feed rod. Feed rod, no, it is not automatically moves, but feed rod will give the support to the another one very important part of the lathe machine, that is called as the carry edge assembly. So this is total is called as the carry edge assembly here now. So this is called as the carry edge assembly here now. So this one I will draw it like this here now. This is a carry edge, this assembly here now. This is called as the carry edge assembly here now. What is this carry edge assembly? This carry edge assembly will engage its rest. It will take a support from this feed rod here now. So here is the one wheel, here hand wheel is there here. By rotating this hand wheel, it will move horizontally like this here. It will move horizontally. It is rotating in one direction, that hand will. It will move one side forward, that is forward movement. And if it rotates in the other opposite direction, then definitely it will move in a backward direction like this here. Here the hand will to control that carry edge assembly. It will move on the feed rod which will give the support to this carry edge. And next one is what about this lead screw? Lead screw. It is here, it is the lead screw engaging that knobs are there here. Lead screw engaging knobs are there here now. Means, if I operate that knob, then only this will operate, this carriage will move with the help of the lead screw. So, it will go with the automatic movement. Then, there is no use of this hand wheel here now. So, definitely the screw will rotates with the help of the gears here. Then it will start moving forward, backward, whatever it is there, automatically it will be set here now. It is used for us that the thread cuttings and all that kind of operations, we are using that one now. That is the lead screw here now. So this is a very important that part here, no? On off of this carriage and controlling, some knobs are there here, no? Here in this case, that knobs are fitted on this. And next one here, this is moving here, no? Carriage is moving here. So next one on this carriage here, no? So under one that very important part, it is called as the compound slide or cross slide. First one is cross slide here. Cross slide is how this one. The cross slide is somewhat, it is like this here. No? Guide wheels are there here. No? Groove guide wheels are there, and this, that is a cross slide here. This is there here. This is a cross slide. Cross slide means what? This cross slide here. Here is the wheel for this cross slide here. Or else here also, that wheels for cross slide. This is the guideways of this cross slide. What it will do here now? So this cross slide, when you are rotating the wheel here, then cross slide will move like this. That is perpendicular to this axis here now. This axis between this center and the chuck is there. This is the axis is the horizontal axis. But this cross slide, by rotating this valve here, this cross slide will move like this here. This is a movement here like this. Carriage will move like this. Cross slide will move like this by the hand. It is operated by the hand here. The next one, above this, there will be the compound slide here. Here is the compound slide here. No? This is a compound slide here. Compound slide. What is this compound slide here? No? Compound slide, it will swivel here like this. So here, this is like this here now. It can swivel. So by operating that valve here, it can be take like this. It can be like that, take like this here now. That means it can swivel, swiveling here now, like this here. Horizontally, it can swivel with a certain angle here now. So next one, on this the compound slide, cross slide, compound slide, then the tool post will comes here now. So this is called as the tool post here now. So this is the tool post. So now see here how this is made here now. The carriage assembly, it is moving horizontally, maybe automatically with the help of the lead screw, maybe manually by the feed rod here now. Feed rod will give the support to the carriage here now. So next one is on which, that is a cross slide is there. Cross slide, by the hand we are moving, which will move perpendicular to this axis here now, like this here. Like this it will move here now. So next one is, that is a here now compound slide here. This compound slide, it will swivel like this, certain angle it will swivel here now, like this here. On which there will be the tool post. In that tool post, tool has been fixed here now. So here the lock nuts are there, here above lock nuts are there. By that lock nuts, tool has been firmly hold like this here. Firmly hold, that is like this here. So therefore, what we can see here now, how many movements we can give for the tool, this one. Now see here, one is carriage is moving horizontally, tool will move horizontally, and cross slide is moving manually perpendicular to this one or like this, tool can move like this also, and the compound slide, it can swivel like this, tool can rotate some certain angle, horizontal plane, in the horizontal plane it can rotate like this. So these are the three movements we can give manually to this tool here now. And horizontal movement can also give automatically in case of the thread cuttings and all here now. So this is about the part of the lathe machine. Just I will glance here now. Main is the bed. It will give the support to all these machines here now. And headstock. This is the arrangement has been made to hold the workpiece with the help of the chuck. Chuck is connected to spindle. Spindle is connected to the motor. Motor has that will give that the motions to the gearbox also. That gearbox is connected to the lead screw here. So next one is, that is a tailstock, which is used to give that the support to the workpiece. What is a rotational support? We can lock at any particular horizontal position also, we can lock it here now. And tailstock, we can use for the drilling purpose also. So therefore, here in place of the center, in the sleeve, if we fit a drill bit, if I fit here now, so if I fit the drill bit here now, so workpiece is like this, if it is a drill bit is there here, so we can make hole like this here. We can make hole by rotating this one, we can make hole also. Drilling is also possible with the help of the tailstock by some arrangement has to be made by removing this center and drill bit, that spindle has to be footed in that. This is one. Next one is here now carriage. Carriage assembly is the main important part to hold the tool here now. How many movements are there? One is a horizontal movement, automatic by the lead screw here, and by the manual here now, that is a feed rod here. And next one is another one movement, it is for the cross line moving perpendicular to this axis here now. And the next one is, that is a compound slide, it can swivel for that tool here now. Tool post will hold the workpiece with the help of the lock nut here now. Switch on, switch off, that knobs are there, everything will be there here now. This is about parts of the lathe machines here now. So usually we have to draw a very neat sketch of this and meaningful sketch, and we have to name the parts, and we should know the each part, that how it is involved in the operations of removing of the metal in case of the lathe machine. Now I will stop here. I will continue in the next video lecture, that is about operations of lathe machines. Thank you very much.